Chernobyl is the first and most famous example of a real-world nuclear accident. But it's not the only time it's happened. There have been nuclear accidents and near meltdowns all across the world. Like Pennsylvania. The site is called the Three Mile Island Nuclear Power Plant, and it was built in 1974 on a strip of sand in the Susquehanna River that's about, well, 3 miles long. Just 4 years after opening, a second state-of-the-art reactor was added, and Three Mile Island became a fully functioning, cutting-edge plant, pumping out cheap and reliable power. All was hunky-dory at the high-tech facility for about another year. Money rolled in, power rolled out, and the two nuclear reactors hummed along without incident. Until overnight, all that changed. At around 4 a.m. on March 28, 1979, the worst nuclear accident ever to occur on U.S. soil began with a bang, as a single pressure valve inside the second reactor malfunctioned. The valve didn't close, which means gallons and gallons of radioactive water that had just been used to cool the reactor drained out into the building and caused the reactor to start overheating. This was bad, really bad. But there was still time to fix it before the whole reactor melted down. The plant had emergency backup systems which kicked into gear, pumping emergency coolant into the reactor to chill everything out. If left to do their thing, these safety features would have been enough to keep the crisis from snowballing out of control. But the people operating the plant kinda sorta freaked out and made things even worse. But it's hard to blame them. For starters, the operators hadn't been fully trained. And even if they had been, the scene was chaotic. Dozens of lights, flashes, buzzers, and alarms were all going off at the same time, all around them. The warnings clashed, the instruments were confusing to read, and before long, someone inevitably made a mistake. They saw the reactors being flooded with water, and thinking that was the cause of the trouble, they shut off the emergency coolant, the only thing keeping the nuclear core from overheating. Though the whole reactor was powered down, there was still tons of heat being released from the mini meltdown that was keeping the core dangerously hot. Just a few hours after the situation started, the reactor was more than 4,000 degrees and getting closer and closer to melting down completely, potentially causing a nuclear catastrophe like Chernobyl. Still reeling from the near meltdown, operators struggled to contain the leak of radioactive water that was releasing toxic gas into the plant. After some effort, crews were able to contain the leak and get all the workers to safety. Eventually, they flooded fresh water back through the reactor and restarted the pumps. Slowly, the temperature dropped and catastrophe was averted. The accident was mostly chalked up to a close call, and it really was close to being much, much worse. At its hottest, the core was less than an hour away from complete meltdown, which would have released untold amounts of deadly radiation into the atmosphere, turning Pennsylvania into a toxic wasteland. But lucky for us all, the reactor held and the operators managed to keep their cool just long enough to avoid a worst-case scenario. Which is no small feat when the stakes are that explosive.